I've made a copy of ODB51, and I'm calling this one ODB52 Combo Box. A combo box is similar to a list box in the way that it shows a list of choices, but a combo box will also allow you to type in a new value. Before we start, I'm going to go over to Tables and open up the Employees Original Table. We're going to be looking at this Group column. And in the Group table, we'll be looking at the group names. Let's go back into Forms. I'm going to make a copy of ODB51 and paste that. We will call this one ODB52 Combo Box. I'm going to right-click and edit our new form. I want to add my combo box with the wizard, so I want to make sure my wizards are turned on, and then I'll click on Combo Box. I'm going to add it for group, so I'm going to add it down here to the right, right next to our group list box. When I release the mouse button, our combo box wizard pops up. LibreOffice Base is asking me what table has the field we want to see in our combo box drop-down list. We want the Employees Original Table. Next. Now it's asking us what field on that table do we want to populate our drop-down list. We want the Group field. This last question is asking us, do we want to update one of the fields on the table attached to the form, or do we just want to show the combo box on the form? We want to update a field on the table connected to the form. So I'll click this radio button. Now I can click the drop-down, and it shows all the fields on the table attached to the form. We want to update the group field. And finish. I'm going to add another combo box, this time without the wizards. And I'll place that right up above our other new combo box. I'm going to open up the Properties control. And I'm in the Data tab. For the Data field, I want the group. And these are all the fields on the table attached to the form. We want the empty string null, yes. Input required, yes. The type of list contents, instead of a table, we want this to be an SQL query. Now for the list content, I'm going to click this dot 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 box, which will open up a dialog box. Here we have the same window that we get when we create a query in Design View. We've seen this many times throughout the video tutorial series. I'm going to insert the group table, add, and close. Now we want to just add in the group name. So I'm double clicking on that to add in the group name. I can run the query and save the query. I'm going to close this window. I'll close our properties dialog box and we'll go into Design View. We can see in our text box, we've got group A. This is our list box that we created in a previous tutorial. We've got group A, then the two combo boxes that we just created. Let's change the value to group C. When I click save, all our controls show group C. Let's try another one. I'll make this group D. Clicking save, all our controls now show it group D. Now let's add one that's not in the table yet. I'll make this group X and click save. We see it updates our text box and our two combo boxes are updated properly, but our list box shows nothing. This is something that we need to keep in mind. The list box only shows values that are in the list box list. The value of the field is group X. But since we don't have group X in our list box list, it's showing as if it's empty. The list box will only show the value if it's in the list box list. Let's change this combo box to group Y and save. Now I'm going to come back up and change it back to group X. We see Y is in the list. When I save it as X, we see that group X and Y are both in the list. Now it saves it in the memory. If we look at our other combo box, we only have the group X. And this is because we use this combo box to type in group X. So it's in the memory. If I save this form, close it, and now reopen it, if we click this drop down again, we see that we only have unknown A, B, C, and D. Remember, it's grabbing these values off of our group table. On the group table, we only have unknown A, B, C, and D. Going back to our form, then if we click on this drop down, we have A, B, C, D, and X. We don't have unknown. And if we look at what we have on our employee's original table, it's doing a select distinct on this group field. And on this one, we don't have any unknowns. But we do have a group X. I don't see it because we need to do the refresh. Now I see group X right here. The last things I want to mention about the combo box are, we cannot use a combo box to update the group ID on the normalized form, because if we type in a new group name, LibreOffice Base won't know what value to give that new group ID. I'll also note that the value list is not available for a combo box for the same reason. LibreOffice Base won't know what value to assign a new field typed in.